Learning how to touch type with your ring and pinky fingers is the most challenging and most rewarding step in learning how to touch type. Once you complete this step, you are officially a touch typist, somebody who can type without looking at the keyboard and who barely has to think about which letter they're typing on the keyboard. In this video, I am going to show you how to get over this final hurdle in your touch typing journey to become a touch typist yourself. Hi everyone, I'm Anson Alexander and welcome to my lesson on typing with your ring and pinky fingers. At this point, you should be comfortable typing all of the letters in the home row, the space bar, the shift key, all of the primary letters typed by the index fingers, and all of the primary letters typed by the middle fingers. If you aren't yet, take a look at some of my earlier lessons at the AnsonAlex.com link in the description or here on YouTube and practice typing those letters and keystrokes until you're comfortable. Okay, now let's talk about the ring and pinky fingers. First of all, why have I grouped them together here in this video? Well, first of all, the ring and pinky fingers present some similar challenges, and to best demonstrate that, I'm going to use a metaphor. And instead of making two videos and kind of going through that metaphor twice, I figured I'd save you some time and do it all here in this one video. Secondly, why is it so challenging to type with these two fingers? Obviously, these fingers have smaller muscles and are used less in daily activities. They aren't as nimble or accurate as your index and middle fingers. When we talk about learning to type with our index and middle fingers, a lot of it is memorizing the keys and then establishing muscle memory. But when we talk about typing with the pinky and ring fingers, oftentimes, before we can actually establish muscle memory, we first need to build up strength and flexibility. Which begs the question, what's the difference between muscle strength, muscle flexibility, and muscle memory? Think about it like this. Pretend your finger is a car and your keyboard is planet Earth. So when we talk about muscle power, we're talking about how fast that car can get to a location or how fast you can get to a key. When we talk about flexibility, we're talking about whether or not that car can reach difficult places. Same with your fingers on a keyboard. Can that pinky finger get all the way over to that top right or top left corner? Is it flexible enough? So for this metaphor, an off-road Jeep has more flexibility than a Ferrari, and a Ferrari has more power than a Jeep. But what about muscle memory? Well, muscle memory is the driver. If the driver has driven to a location many times, they probably know all of the shortcuts, the traffic patterns, where the parking spaces are, etc. However, if they've never been to a place, they might have to use GPS or even worse, maps. And on their way, they might take a wrong turn, aka hit a wrong key, or they might not be able to find their destination at all, aka I don't know where that key is on the keyboard. So learning to touch type with the index and middle fingers is all about training the driver, making sure that they have the route memorized and that they're comfortable with it. The two cars that we're using, the index and middle fingers, have plenty of power and flexibility, so we don't need to worry about that. With the ring fingers, however, not only is the driver likely clueless, but the cars themselves resemble old beat-up junk cars that can barely even make it down the road. Instead of a good driver's ed class, we also need major improvements in power and flexibility. So back in touch typing world, what does that mean? That's right, you already know, lots of practice. It's important to understand this because these fingers will probably lead you to your highest points of frustration and exhaustion when you're learning how to touch type. This is totally understandable, and it's totally the reason that learning how to touch type is so empowering. You're taking a part of your body that is often overlooked as weak and useless, and you are giving it a superpower to allow you to create and communicate at lightning speed. So stick with it. The end result is worth it. So let's take a look at the keys typed by the ring and pinky fingers, what the keystrokes look like, and then we'll look at the best ways that we can practice them to complete our touch typing training. The left ring finger, in addition to its home row key of S, is also responsible for the keys 2, W, and X. The right ring finger, in addition to its home row key of L, is also responsible for the keys 9, O, and period. Realize that O and period are two very common and essential keys. O is a vowel that's used in many words, and period is used in, well, every sentence. Learning these two keystrokes will speed up your typing tremendously. Okay, let's talk about the pinky fingers. The left pinky in addition to its home row key of A, is also responsible for the primary keys of 1, Q, and Z. Notice that on the finger chart, the left pinky is also responsible for the tab key, the caps locks key, and the tilde key. That's the one to the left of the 1 key. We'll keep our practice focused around the primary keys, but as you become more comfortable, you may want to branch out and build muscle memory with these other keys as well, depending on your workflow. Ready for the right pinky? As weak as it may seem, you may be surprised to find out that your right pinky is responsible for more keys on the keyboard than any other finger. The right pinky, in addition to its home row key of semicolon, is also responsible for the primary keys of 0, P, and forward slash. Notice that on the finger chart, it's also responsible for all of the keys to the right of its primary keys on the keyboard. This includes the quote key, the brackets key, the backslash key, the minus and plus key, and the backspace or delete key. Wow, you never thought your right pinky would have so much responsibility, did you? We'll also focus on the primary keys when practicing the right pinky, but I do encourage you to use the delete or backspace key when you're practicing or working. Adding this key to your muscle memory is essential when you're first learning how to type. You'll be making lots of mistakes, so it's a perfect opportunity to learn this key and never look back. Okay, we've covered the responsibilities for the left and right pinky fingers. So now what? You know, it's time to practice. Start in the same way that we have in previous videos. Open up a blank document and start to type the new letters repetitively, always returning to the home row in between. If it isn't clear why this is helpful, returning to the home row, then I suggest that you take a look at my lesson on learning the middle finger, as it gave a very detailed explanation as to why this is helpful. I'm also going to add some practice sentences to antsandalex.com that exclude the pinky fingers so that you can practice typing full words and sentences with all of your fingers except those until you're ready to move on. Remember that you're not going to learn all of these keystrokes in a day. Just because I lumped them into one video doesn't mean that they're easier to learn. In fact, they're probably going to be harder to learn because of the fingers that we're talking about. So remember to dedicate specific time to practicing, and it may be helpful to practice building muscle memory in one finger this week and another finger next week and so forth until you've gone through all of them. Even if you're not typing very fast or very accurate yet, if you've memorized all of the keys on the keyboard, you have made it to a very pivotal point in your typing journey. First of all, you can now practice more efficiently because you know where all of the keys are, so now it's just about repetition. Secondly, you can now perform all of your daily tasks by touch typing and without looking at the keyboard. Even if it's a little bit slower right now because you're just getting started, don't worry. If you're not looking at the keyboard and you're touch typing, your speed is going to increase the more that you do it. Finally, and most excitingly in my opinion, you are now ready to jump into some full-fledged typing games. Practicing with typing games is difficult before you've memorized where all of the keys are. Because of the time factor in most typing games, you're kind of forced to look at the keyboard if you don't know where a key is, which makes you end up cheating, and then you don't end up building that muscle memory in the same way, and you never really learn things the same. So that's why I haven't mentioned that until this video in the course, because you need to know where all the keys are before you can start using these typing games and applications where it's asking you to type pretty much any key on the keyboard. My favorite game at the current moment is called Nitro Type. It's essentially a car racing game, but you can upgrade and improve the looks and animations of your car as you go. There are different seasons with different rewards, and you can join teams for even more fun. I've also been known to live stream playing Nitro Type a time or two, so keep an eye out for that. Remember, you are so close to the end, and boy is it sweet. Honestly, when you get there, you will be able to type at blazing speed, and you will not even have to think about typing ever again in your life if you don't want to. If you master the basics of touch typing and are looking for an extra speed boost, don't forget to check out my video called Type Faster Than Ever, where I divulge a secret method used for advanced typers to take them from around that 100 words per minute level and get them closer and closer to typing at 200 words per minute or beyond. Also, don't forget that I've authored a full touch typing course available on LinkedIn Learning, and I have a ton of additional typing instruction available at antsandalex.com. All of the links are in the description. If you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more touch typing lessons and tips, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. I'll see you in the typing races. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.